hope you must have heard about the Greta Thunberg effect. A 15-year-old teenager from Sweden stopped going to school and has become an environmental activist for climate change. After her famous "How dare you" speech, this girl has become a force in fighting climate change and in creating awareness about our environment. Welcome to my channel Gold Mage. I'm Priya and I'm really glad to see you here one more time. Every now and then, all of us hear about climate change, global warming, rising sea levels, melting ice glaciers in the Arctic, or extinction of endangered species, so on and so forth. But you know what, my friends? I got my reality check about climate change this year, very recently, when I was hearing about all these shocking incidents. I'm doing this video with a very genuine interest to share some of my thoughts about the responsibilities that each one of us must take towards our environment. So with no further delay, now let's get inside the video. Nature. See, when I say this, I am no biologist or an environmentalist, but I come from this space, this strong belief system that all of us love Mother Nature and all of us care for our environment. It's just that we may not really know what we are doing to our environment, or we may think our actions towards protecting the environment could be insignificant. But when I remind you of these three horrifying incidents that happened this year to our world, I'm 100% sure it will melt your heart and will push you towards new environmental goals. Incident number one happened on Jan 2019. See, when all of us began our new year with lots of happiness and hope, it was not a great beginning for at least 3 million fishes which were found dead in the Menindee Lakes of Australia. Can you imagine 3 million fishes dying because of water contamination? Because of altering water temperature, these fishes were deprived of oxygen and they were stranded to death. How tragic and painful. Incident number two happened on July 2019. Amazon rainforest, which is known as the planet's lungs, caught on fire. All of us must have seen this in the news. But can you imagine up to 7,200 square miles of Amazon rainforest has been burned, and they are saying still there are parts which are burning and it's very, very hard to control. Scientists say that at least 20% of the oxygen for Earth comes from Amazon rainforest, and this fire is going to really worsen the climate change. Third incident really shook me up because this happened in our country last week in Rajasthan. Sambar Lake is the largest inland saltwater lake of India, and every year during the winter season, migrating birds in tens and thousands come, relax and be there. Thousands of tourists visit Sambar Lake to see all these bird species. But unfortunately, last week, thousands of birds were found dead in Sambar Lake. And now in news we are hearing that it's up to 10,000 migrated birds have been found dead near or around the lake. See, because of the mistakes that mankind does, fishes, birds, trees are being affected. My intention to do this video is not to report about all the tragic incidents around climate change and say that the world is going to end. I am saying, whenever mistake happens, that is where we have got the opportunity to correct. See, when I was doing a little research about how to reduce my carbon footprint in this world, I found something very interesting. Do you know which is the most carbon intensive activity that a human can do? Flying. And I did not know this all this while. See, there is this whole movement called Fleek Scam or Flight Shame that started this year to promote slow travel. The intention of this particular movement is to reduce the flight travels and can take train or by road whenever possible. See, generally, I travel a lot for my training programs and I have the habit of taking domestic flights. A lot of studies are showing that if we slow down a little bit and embrace minimalism in our life, that can do a whole lot of contribution towards our environment. So now I'm taking this conscious decision that if I can reach a destination within 5 to 8 hours, I will definitely embrace slow travel. I will either take a train or go by road rather than opting for a flight. This is one small thing that I can do for my environment. So much for watching this video, and I hope this video would have really inspired you to have one goal towards the environment. And if you really like the content in this video, please give me a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Hit that subscribe button. I need all your encouragement, and I will see you soon in another video. Until then, take good care of yourself. Bye-bye.